定要坚定前行，为各阶层的社市民带来希望，促进社会的向上流动。今年的施政报告是承先启后，敢于创新，充分展现出现届政府的政治的勇气、决心、承担和远见。这个可以说是一份不一样、不平凡的施政报告。土地供应和房屋问题是一个最辣手的问题，政府我们始至是扭转这个局势，大刀阔斧地是增加土地和房屋的供应。其中一个亮点就是政府建议通过一个明日大屿的愿景建议，提供26万至40万个的住宅单位，其中70%是公共房屋，容纳70万至110万人口。其次，特区政府亦都会我哋秉持以人为本同埋急民之所急嘅施政理念咧，致力系聆听、关怀、行动，同埋以创新、互动、协作嘅原则咧，同社会各界咧系结伴同行。多项民生嘅措施咧，有几项系特别值得大家留意嘅咧。第一就系加大同埋延长咧，政府就取消强积金同埋遣散费同埋长服金个对冲嘅安排嘅承担额咧，系高达293亿元。第二就是提供額外的經常開支15亿元，是為公營的中小學一次過將教師的職位是全面學位化，這是一個很重要的一個改善。第三就是提供額外的經常開支是8亿元，為有特殊教育需要的學童加強教育心理學家和願意治療的服務。第四就是延長產假，是由現在10个星期是到14个星期。第五就是建議立法全面禁止電子香煙。第六就是在葵青區設立我們香港第一個的地區的康健中心，以及在各區的地區是康健中心以提升市民的健康和預防疾病的意識。其他就是將中醫藥納入本港醫療系統重要的組成部分，同時也是設立一個5亿元的專項基金，是促進中醫的發展。其他兩項就是豁免或者繳付專營巴士因為使用政府或者專營的隧道或者道路收費，是舒緩加價的壓力，這個亦都令到我們廣大的乘客會受惠。最後就是動用超過5亿元，是加強支援我們香港的少數族裔。現屆政府我們會繼續發揮促成者、推廣者的角色，是推動香港的長遠經濟、社會民生的發展，大力投資在教育方面、創新和科技，提升我們的傳統行業的優勢，改善民生，是推動優質生活，讓政府和社會各界不同界別、不同種族、不同年齡的組群的市民攜手向前邁進，建立一個充滿希望和機遇的未來。或者我講幾句英文，The theme of the Chief Executive's second policy address just now is Striving Ahead, Rekindling Hope. This well-chosen theme underlines the determination of the current term government to propel Hong Kong forward in face of increasingly fierce regional and global competition. We also need to bring hope to all sectors of the community and vigorously promote upward social mobility. We have rolled out altogether 244 new measures. They fully reflect the government's political courage to tackle difficult tasks head on. We are resolute and persistent in confronting the various long entrenched and deep-seated problems. Land and housing supply is the most thorny issue, as we all know. The Chief Executive has announced a package of measures to boost housing supply in the short to medium term. With the completion of various infrastructure projects, Lantau will become the double gateway to the world and the Greater Bay Area. In order to capture various competitive advantages and opportunities of Lantau, and for the long-term benefits of Hong Kong, we are going to launch the Lantau Tomorrow Vision Project, which will provide 260,000 to 400,000 housing units, of which 70% are for public housing, accommodate 700,000 to 1.1 million people, at the same time provide 360,000 jobs there. We will continue to care, listen and act on the basis of the principles of interactive, innovative and collaborative to implement people-oriented measures for a better and more harmonious Hong Kong. We'll roll a number of major initiatives to improve people's livelihood on all fronts. Let me quote a few key examples. First, we'll enhance substantially financial support for employers and micro and small medium enterprises in preparing them for the abolition of the mandatory provident fund offsetting arrangement. This would cost the government $29.3 billion over 25 years. We'll provide $1.5 million recurrent spending to implement all graduate teaching force policy, a very important iconic measure. We'll provide $800 million recurrent funding again to enhance educational psychologists and speech therapy services for students with special education needs. We'll extend statutory maternity leave from 10 weeks to 14 weeks. We'll legislate for a ban on electronic cigarettes across the board. We'll strengthen primary health care services by setting up the first district health center in Kwai Ching and extending this model to other districts over time. We'll recognize the positioning of Chinese medicine services in Hong Kong's healthcare system and set up a $500 million fund to promote Chinese medicine applied research. We'll also waive or pay for the tolls charged on enfranchised buses for using government or franchised tunnel roads to ease fare increase pressure, particularly on the commuters. And of course, we also draw on over $500 million funding allocation to enhance support for our ethnic minorities in Hong Kong. The current term government will continue to perform our role as facilitator and promoter, and also proactively foster Hong Kong's long-term economic and social development, provide more land for housing and future economic activities, reinforce Hong Kong's advantages by stepping up investment in education, as well as innovation and technology, scale up our established industries, improve people's livelihood, and of course, promote quality living. In short, our aim is for the government to join hands with the whole community to build a future full of hope of opportunities. Thank you very much indeed. 这件事呢，我们是已经昨天行政总会很清楚已经说明了，如果有任何的上诉收到的话，我们要跟既定程序去处理，这个就是我们最新的跟大家交代，所以一定是有既定程序去处理这件事。多谢你。
左 S